good Danish or German duo of Fabian Holzer and Mark Lamfuss.
Ready to play?
I think for the Aden Hall, that's very good. And have a R.BLAIR player, world class player, then play with. So it's a fantastic opportunity for Aden Hall.
Yeah, really, he couldn't ask for much better as a youngster coming through to have a world championship silver medalist, I think,
yes,
from 2006
exactly. Yeah.
In Spain. I was at that championships as a spectator sitting watching. I remember it very, very well.
And R.BLAIR had so many like mixed doubles in the top 10 with Gabby White, then with the Imogen Banker. So I think R.BLAIR play have so much experience on court. And Aden Hall can learn a lot from him. And of course, on this match, I think he will learn a lot. Gain a lot of experience.
R.BLAIR Blair, Aden Hall, Scotland. On my left.
But Aden actually is quite a talented young player.
R.BLAIR Blair to serve.
His racquet skill quite skillful.
Yeah, I saw him play some mixed doubles with Julie McPherson.
Oh,
yes. Very, very good, the pair together. Great experience for them here this week.
Same again, Aden Hall is the same as Kirsty Gilmour, come out from that Glasgow School Sports as well. So
Holzer and Lamfuss have been together since the Scottish Open here last year. So 1 year in operation. And while not setting the world alight with wins, they've been very consistent with semi-finals and quarter-finals, quarter-finals at the Swiss, semi-finals at the Belgian, quarter-finals at the Spanish, quarter-final at the Dutch, and a quarter-final in Romania, semi-final at the Irish Open in Dublin in 2013. And they're world-ranked 64.
And is this first tournament for Aden Hall and R.BLAIR Blair?
Yep. Right. Their first time together. Youth and experience.
Good shot from.
Certainly great to see Bob giving so much back, getting in and getting involved with the youngsters and playing with the young guys.
Oh, well done.
3-2.
When R.BLAIR Blair was bursting onto the international scene, Aden Hall wasn't even born.
No. Is it? You sure?
Well. Pretty close anyway.
Set of 3-0.
I remember just talking about coaching. Just started to coach, then on that time, Kirsty Gilmour was 12 in the Glasgow School Sports, and Aden hasn't been in the Glasgow School Sports yet, but he was just on the primary, so we took them to some tournament. He was there playing, losing on the court, and cry, and keep crying, but still playing.
Okay.
So cute. But that's long, long time ago. I think it's 2006. But certainly a bit determination from the young player.
5-4.
Doesn't like to lose. That was a very good net player. Or I'll just say that was a very good net control from Aden. Control well on the front court.
Fault call on the serve.
5-6.
Okay.
Same again, Adam did quite well on the front. Oh, good shot.
6-0.
I wonder how long Robert Blair will keep going. Of course, the World Championships now due to be staged here in 2 years' time. Is that something that you think Robert might focus on?
I think he would, yes, because recently I spoke to him. I said, would you keep playing? And he said, yes, I would just keep playing because at the moment he still enjoy it. Mm-hmm. I think if I'm him, if I'm enjoying the game, why not? Just keep going. But of course, I don't know about Olympics qualification. I think maybe will be very tough. Depends if you got partner or not. Of course, in the doubles and the mix, always is harder than singles.
Yeah, it's so difficult. You need to be almost inside the world's top 12 or 13 to guarantee qualification.
For the doubles, it's like doubles and the mix. Singles slightly easier, I think, in this case.
Singles, if you're inside 60, you're almost guaranteed to make it.
Depends each country criteria.
Depends on the country, of course, yeah.
10-6.
It depends, of course, if you've anybody else in your own country that's equally as good. When you get two players battling it out for qualification, it can be very, very intense.
Yes. I remember in... On that day's Olympic qualification, they were talking about in Switzerland, and they have a criteria. They end up Sabrina Jacket getting the criteria, but Shanin was higher ranking than Sabrina Jacket.
Or remember, Sabrina, by virtue of getting to the quarterfinal of the European Championships, achieved qualification.
But in terms of just ranking, but Shanin Chikuni is much higher than Sabrina.
Of course, Jeanine now playing for Italy.
Yes.
That was the last straw for Jeanine, I think.
That is a bit of a surprise from Switzerland, I think.
Yeah. Another good young Swiss, Nicole Schaller, of course, not in the Swiss national team anymore. She trains outside of the national.
But I believe she's still good enough to try, I mean, to get qualification.
Yeah,
would be interesting to see who I get in this time.
It'll be the same type of scenario again in Switzerland. It'll be two players going for the one spot.
Yeah. But I think in that term is always quite good. Two players, you keep competition each other to get one spot, so you get to that level a bit higher.
So 12-7, the Germans are leading.
13-7?
13-7 now.
That's very fast to come out from German. Good serve and hunt to the front court.
Yeah, won 6 of the last 7 points to Germans. Seven.
Yeah, he got actually a very good serve, in fact.
Fabian H.Holzer active in the rear court, and then Robert Blair.
Robert Blair was good on the front, fantastic shot.
Yeah, rack it up, always active. And again, always in discussion with his young partner. Oh, good crouch defense from Hall. Beautifully placed in the corner by Blair.
10-14.
Ooh, Ooh.
11, 14.
Smash coming very close to the head of Mark Lamfus from Fabian Holzer. You'll see it here. Lift.
Set over 15, 11. Oh, well done, Adam, on the front. Cover very well. Rack it up 15. And get a finish your shot.
Straight
forecourt. Say so. 16, 12. Was that a false
serve? Mark Lamfus serving to Adam Hall. Oh, very poor shot 12. From R.BLAIR. R.BLAIR immediately looking for the shuttle to be changed. Judgment from Lamfus. Shuttle from Blair landing a long 17. Way in.
Play.
And again, R.BLAIR player finding the 14, space in 15. Behind Mark Lamfus.
The German tried to keep the shuttle pressure on Aden, but Aden did quite well on the defense this one.
Yeah, run of 3 points in a row on the serve of R.BLAIR player.
Oh. 18-15.
Aden's just not quick enough, but Robert did quite well on the serve to gain quite a few points. I think German will be keep trying to put pressure on Aden all the time from now on.
Yeah, they'll certainly focus on the more inexperienced Scottish men, and certainly, you know, R.BLAIR player has been there and done everything in world badminton.
Oh. 20. Game point, 15.
5 game points for the Germans.
If you notice the last few points and then Adam made a mistake, I think it's just still quite young, not quick enough.
What age is he, Rita?
I think he 16, is only 19.
20. Only 19. Mm.
Okay. 18 or 19, I think.
He looks so young compared to all the other four.
Yeah, of course he got great potential on the long term.
It's good play, well finished off by Hall.
17-20.
I forgot to say, apparently he baked a very good bacon cake. There was Yvette's birthday, he baked a cake. I was like, very nice, Aden.
In the end, an easy put away by the Germans, and they take the first game, 21-17. Good control. Both pairs exchanged early salvos, matching each other point for point. early in the game, and then the Germans going on a run of winning 8 points from nine, and that really set the tone. There was flashes of brilliance from Robert Blair and of course the young talent of Adam Hall, but in the end it's Germans coming out on top, 21-17, and 13 minutes gone in this men's doubles. So H.O.L.Z.E.R. and L.A.M.F.U.S.S. already back out on court, ready to go. Still discussions going on. You can see Yvette.
I think they're trying to throw everything to Adam. It's a bit too much information. He can't get in.
Yeah.
Feel like he had enough. Don't want to listen anymore. If you look at the screen. Right, let's see this time get a bit better.
Love on. Play.
Oh, shot well done.
Sets of one, love. Ball, that's for court.
Oh.
Sets of one.
Was that a false serve?
False serve call against Robert. Racket head above the horizontal.
Good drive. Oh, well done. Adam did very good on the defense, on the good drives, and make themselves on attack position.
Flick serve.
Unlucky serve, but it was good flick serve.
Three, two.
I think they were misunderstanding each other on that shot.
Oh. Bob's getting a little bit lucky. Shuttle tumbling over the net.
Four, three.
Mistake by Adam, easily finished off by Fabian H.O.L.Z.E.R. Oh, beautiful interception again from H.O.L.Z.E.R.
5-4.
Good defense, looking for the gap on that one. Settling few points on the serve of Adam Hall. Two in a row levels the Scots up at 6-6 with the Germans.
6-7-6.
Final smash from L.A.M.F.U.S.S.
8-6.
Down.
Was very fast on the front court, that L.A.M.F.U.S.S. on that shot.
Still only a young man, I think only 20 years of age, Mark L.A.M.F.U.S.S.
All right, that's quite young as well. Mm-hmm. How about Hoss?
I'm not sure about Holzer, but certainly Lamfuss played juniors in the 2013 European Juniors.
Seven,
Is that in Ankara? Yeah.
Yeah. Beautiful play again from Mark Lamfuss. Scrambling
seven.
Back behind.
He's very, look like he's a very talented player as well. Got quite good skill.
Quite thin frame, but he used to be much skinnier and in the last year certainly developed a little bit more physically. Really gone from a boy to a man.
Right. Well done, Arden, on that rally.
Oh. Trying to find the space behind Lamfuss, but
same again. That Lamfuss is very fast on the front court on that finish of the shot.
Yeah, and he was ready for it. You'll see it here, racket up, ready for the interception. Another service fault called. That's two in this match. Too high.
Eight, ten.
Nice return from the German.
Over.
Beautiful Lamp touch eight. From Lamfuss at the net, just caressing the shuttle back across on the return of serve. And yet again, it's the interval lead for the Germans, 11-8, after taking the first game, 21-17. 20 minutes played. And the Germans, I think, just looking the more complete player pair, Rita.
Yes, the Germans look much more stable than the Scots. Instead, Scots, some shot is really good, and then sometimes, and then somehow I feel like Arden's just still like quite young for the game, sometimes just lack a bit of concentration or maybe slow down a little bit. Couldn't just keep the pace all the time. In this game, the service judge quite restrict quite a lot of fault. So the player has to be careful in here.
Play. 12-8. 9-12.
Let's hope the Scottish pair gets a few points back to the level. Oh, good flex serve, I just said, from Robert. In the men's doubles, you got to concentrate all the time. And then otherwise, you would lose point quite really easy. Oh, well done, Bob.
Yeah, beautiful interception from Bob Blair. Good few points again now for the Scots. Back within touching distance, just one behind.
Yeah, I think they just rely a couple of good serve again. Good serve, good start.
From nowhere, they've leveled it up at 12 all, 4 points in a row. Holzer just moving Bob Blair around the rear court, and then the Germans switching the attack for the younger of the two Scots, Adam Hall.
Nine. Adam has to focus on try to get shot or over, and otherwise they will just keep attacking him all the time.
6 over 14 13.
Good jump smash from Lamphus.
Out. 6 over 14.
Short serve. Free point to the Scots. Yeah, and that landing in.
6 over 15 14.
And on the replay, you see Adam Hall scampering.
Six over 15 all.
Oh, well done, Adam. That was a good job from Robert. And Adam saw the shot come and go forward 16, one step and finish the shot. Well done, Adam, I would say.
The Germans focusing that
attack.
They've
got to focus on the middle and the front. And oh.
Yeah, just out. Unlucky. The Germans concentrating and pushing it in. And that
16.
Attack all on the younger of the Scots, Adam Hall. Unlucky. Just out from Adam Hall. Poor backhand. We saw that, and that's certainly his weak point.
Yeah, on this time you've got to not can't afford to have a simple errors.
Yeah, we saw it in the mixed doubles. It's an area that Mark Lamphus needs to work on, and certainly on the backhand side. Excellent overhead, super power in his smash, good control, and that time going around the head for the smash. And that's what he needs to do more than that, rather than taking it on the backhand side.
Adam needs to get back to the game, I think, and otherwise they will keep pressure him again, like same as the last set. Same as the first set, sorry. See, same again, they will keep pressure on him.
19-17.
Two quick points for the Germans.
19-17. Let's hope the Scottish can get a few points.
Beautiful smash. Really steep from Adam.
6 over 18 19.
As quickly as the Germans won two quick ones, the Scots come back with an equal. Speedy 2 points, tied up at 19 all. Lamphus forced to lift. Nice flat drive cross court from Adam Hall.
Well done, Adam. Now they've got opportunity to win this set. I think Robert can do good serve, especially the experienced world-class players. I see.
Oh, it looked as if it was going to be short.
Oh.
And in the end, 4 points in a row. And the Scots take the second game.
I just say Robert can do a good serve, almost a short.
I think it was short. And I think he was lucky that Mark Lamphus
get over.
Took it and played it. But in the end, 4 points in a row. And it's the Scots who take the second game and take this men's doubles into a deciding set. It's the final game on our streaming court before the quarterfinals start, of course, at 5 p.m.
It's interesting. The coach only just talking with Adam. Doesn't talk with a Bob. For a half a game.
Final game, love all, play. Sets of one, love.
Right, okay, Max is away, then Dan Travers is back on the air.
Sets of one,
what do you say, Dan, about this games? So far looking quite well. The robot did quite good job. And the same again, Adams did a very good job on this court as well.
Yeah, Bob served particularly well there when it was tight at the end from 17 and out to 21.
Oh, well
yeah,
done,
Adam. I think Adams gained a lot of confidence for winning that. And I would hope they would go on and win from here. It'll still be tough, but I think Bob is real quality, and he should be able to control things and get through this one.
The game will be tough, but so far I think Adam did quite well. The German pair keep the pressure on Adam, and some rally he get over, so he did quite good job on here as well.
Yep. Thought his third shot was very good there when it was tight at the end of the second, when Bob was serving well. He got a lot of power off a short forehand. Did very well. It's good to see Bob playing the shuttle across. That means he's not afraid of them hitting at him.
Good drive on Adam. Really, I think Adam needed a pressure to watch on the front court. Sometimes he just stood on the middle.
Yeah, I think Bob was telling them there, we've got to press the net, look to go forward at every opportunity.
Sets of three, four.
Oh, well done. On
that was very good
again.
From Adam there, good return. Slightly lucky hitting the net cord, but he did well to follow it in and take the shuttle off the top of the tape there.
Six, three.
Bob is so good at the front of the court.
We nice. Just said earlier, Lamsfuss is quite young as well. He's only 20. And he actually did quite well in this court as well. And Adam is 19, is it? Yeah, they were just asking me earlier. Oh, sorry, so Adam Hall is only 18. As mentioned earlier, I said that he's 19, so he's only 18. So he's still got another European Junior Championship to go, is
yep.
it?
Yep.
So he's got a lot of potential to go. Good future ahead for Adam Hall.
Yeah, he can't afford to do that, Adam, from behind. When he's hitting flat there, the Germans are mid-court each with their rackets up, looking to get onto it very early.
The shot up behind, you just cannot hit the smash. Then you end up getting smashed over. Oh, well done, Adam. Good defense from him. But I have to say, they were a bit lucky. The German a bit unlucky, made that mistake. Good return from Lamsfuss.
Yeah, very good. I saw him play that a couple of times this morning in the mixed. Very good shot.
Got quite good racket skill and also quite good serve, I noticed, on this game.
And he's got quite a good hit as well, Rita.
Future bright for him again.
Yeah, the only weakness in his play I saw this morning, really, in the mix, was his backhand side.
Yeah, actually, we just mentioned earlier about his backhand. Slip on the racket, I guess.
Yeah, they've just been a little bit sloppy here, the two Scots lads. Letting the German player back into it.
It's full serve again.
Yep.
I just say this game, the serve is just very strict, so the player really need to be careful they serve. If I'm on this court, then I will certainly keep my racket down all the time.
Good smash there, coming into the body of Robert. On the service though, Rita, I think it's good to see a service judge fault some players, especially as they're not Scots. But all joking aside, I do think it's good because some of the heights the players serve at today, sometimes when you look at it, you wonder if the law's been
stopped. It's just unbelievable.
Yeah.
As serious, I don't know when you're teaching the young kids what service is good, what service is fault. Because when I say you need a lower, and the young kids say, look at that Danish player, look at that whatever Chinese player, they serve almost on the head.
Yeah, and they never get faulted.
So it's good to see the service judge a bit restrict on here.
11-9 interval.
Yeah, the Scots just have let the lead go there. It was 8-4 up, and now they're 11-9 down.
Yeah, they just kind of to me they look a bit concentrated. Wherever they lost a few easy points and just slipped away.
Yep, you've got to stay focused at this level all the time.
We were just talking about yesterday, once they change, if they change to 11, the men's double will be very quick.
Yep. A lot of pressure. I was speaking with Mark earlier today. It'd be a lot of pressure on the server. Service would be so important. Probably quite good for the game. You'd see a lot of players practicing their serve a lot more than they do now, because it would be vital.
So first three shot, would we say, serve, return, and the next one?
Yep, you'll see very few points won in defence. So if you get the chance to hit down at this level, you've got to keep it, try and maintain the attack, and then pick your shots, hit the right angles to bring the person at the front of the court in. That was very good from Adam there. Very good.
Fantastic shot.
10-11.
Played a lovely block and then moved forward with a racket up, looking to tap it down. Very successful there.
Shot at Robert. Oh, very fast, Robert. That one's very good.
11-0.
Yeah, he's very quick with the racket, Robert, at the forecourt. Maybe not so quick with his feet these days, but he's still a fantastic player. It's a very good smash from Adam there. The German boy was backhand bias and he tried to take the shuttle which was going towards his inside hip on his backhand. Forced the error from him.
So, see, Dan, you coach in Scotland for many years. You say Adam's quite talented. Uh-huh. And was Bob that age like the Adam? When Bob was 18, 17, was like Adam?
I would have said Bob was ahead. There was nothing Robert couldn't do when he was a junior. He was very fast, very powerful, had all the shots.
13,
and any time I worked with him, he had a fantastic badminton brain and went on, obviously, to win a silver in the World Championships in men's doubles. And but it was just a physical thing when he was young. He had everything else he needed. He just needed to build himself up a little.
But I heard when he was young, he was a singles player. He was quite good in the singles player, is it?
Yeah, when he was 17 or 18, we went to America and he played the top seed, a Chinese fella, and he won the first set.
Wow.
But he just couldn't keep it up. But it was intensity of training he needed then, and he obviously got that in England, and now he's back in Scotland. And we're delighted to have him back because he's genuine quality. But as a young man, there was never any doubt for me if he put the effort in that he could achieve anything. He's got the one thing.
So I would say he achieved quite success.
Oh, yeah. Yep. I think he's a wonderful player.
So he's quite happy in Scotland now.
Yeah, I think so.
14, 13.
They've got to try and keep the attack here. That's what I feel is critical. If they're attacking, I think they will win. But if they're going to lift the shuttle to the two boys, both Germans hit it quite hard. And they've been playing together for a while, and they know each other's game.
Yeah, they both play. It's like a partner. They're walking to.
That's a big hit there, because Robert's got a very, very good defence, and that to get through him.
Serve again.
Come on! 16,
13. Oh, unlucky.
17, that was 13. Unlucky, but.
Both play hunt well on the front court. Lamfus, yeah, he got very good serve so far.
Yep, I'm very impressed with him here, Rita. He's very cool, and he's shown a lot more coolness than he did this morning, and he's mixed. For me, he's the dominant player on court at the moment.
Yeah, in this court, he did really well. Be mind, he's only 20 as well, so he got long way to go. Bright future for him.
19-13.
That's a bad mistake from Adam.
It looks like the German's going to finish this game.
Oh.
Fantastic return.
He didn't play a backhand like that this morning, I'll tell you that. If he had, he would have won his mixed. He kept playing them and they were floating over the court this morning.
Backhand defense. Four.
And he went for that as well. That's how 14, confident he 20. Is.
Oh, well done defense from Adam.
Yeah,
but maybe it's a bit too late.
Yeah, it may well be too late, Rita, but it was very good defence from the Scottish pair.
Would have been amazing if they win now. Well done again.
16-20.
I mean, obviously, every serve's critical at this stage, but I think this is critical. I think Lamfus may jump this.
Jump on the serve.
Okay. Well, he didn't need to. But so the Germans go through at the expense of the Scots.
Well done, the Germans. So Germany gets through the quarter, is it? Yeah.
Quarter final now.
Match won by Fabian Holzer, Mark Lamfus, 21-17, 19, 21, 21, 16.
To Dan sitting in for me there and Rita, that's the end of the third round action. As you can see, players leaving the court, winners Fabian Holzer and Mark Lamfus in three games. I think very well played by the Scots, and certainly a future talent in Adam Hall. We will sign off and we're back with the quarter finals from 5 o'clock. And the first match on court in those quarterfinals is scheduled to be Scotland's own top seed Kirsty Gilmour against Sweden's Eleanor Vid. So until then, we'll sign off and say thank you for joining us, and my thanks again to all the co-commentators. Join us again at 5 for that women's singles. It'll be Kirsty Gilmour, top seeded Scot, against Eleanor Vid of Sweden.
Excuse my language. Be careful of the microphone.